New tonight at 6, a jury has recommended a sentence for Lindley Renick. They found Renick guilty of second-degree murder and armed criminal action in the death of her husband, Ben Renick. Good evening, everyone. I'm Noah Klein. Thanks so much for joining us. The jury recommended a sentence of 13 years for second-degree murder and 3 years for armed criminal action. KMU8's Peyton Headley has been following this trial since it began. She was in the courtroom today as the judge read that jury's verdict. Peyton, tell us what today's decision means.
Within the hour, the jury came back from deliberation in the sentencing phase. They recommended a 13-year sentence for the conviction of second-degree murder and a 3-year sentence for the conviction of armed criminal action. And just before that, as the judge read that guilty verdict to the courtroom, Lindley started crying. And as the jury left, she broke down and started sobbing to her attorneys and her dad. And just after that, the sentencing phase kicked off with character testimony about Lindley.
She's told me more times than I could count that she feels like she's incomplete without the kids.
In the past 4 days, the prosecution was shown text messages from Lindley's phone, photos of Ben's dead body, and the couple's financial records. They say they all placed Lindley at the scene of the crime and showed deliberation in the murder of her husband. The defense argued that Lindley and two others created a plan just to go to his business, just to discuss divorce. They repeatedly said it was ex-boyfriend Michael Humphrey who fired the 8 shots that killed Ben Renick. Humphrey was originally convicted of first-degree murder at his trial, but that verdict was reduced to second-degree murder after cooperating with investigators in the Renick case. Now, the jury deliberated for 12 hours over a span of 2 days before they came to that guilty verdict. The last testimony they heard was from Lindley Renick herself. She took the stand and emotionally told the jury she never killed her husband and she never wanted him dead. Now, right after the trial wrapped up for the day, we talked to a family friend of Ben Renick. She said, "This isn't justice." And apparently in Missouri, the cost of a life is only 13 years. Reporting live in Columbia, Peyton Headley, KOMU8 News.
Peyton, thank you. And let's look in depth here, because after today's verdict, I caught up with former Cole County Prosecutor Bill Tackett for his take on how the jury reached this decision.
This looks very much like some trials in the past where sexual abuse by the victim, right, the snake handler, played a role. And that's happened before where there's been a lesser penalty. We actually call it the he needed killing verdict, all right, because it's somebody that, put this woman through hell or sexually abused her. That's the only real explanation for this, because you have the jury saying, yes, he killed her. Well, 8 bullets, 1 in the back of the head, you don't give 13 years unless you have cause to believe that she needs a break.
Tonight on KMU8 News at 10, more from that interview, including whether or not Bill Tackett believes Lindley taking the stand in her own defense helped or hurt her in the end. In other court